I don't have the greatest selection in yarn choices, so like literally the only bulky options I have right up here. So that's what I picked a couple colors from that. Just cranking away on my first test with Janine. I met her at Arm Maker Life in Calgary, and little did I know that we would become such good friends. I have not got the chance to test for her before, and this cardigan just looks so freaking cute. And it's Tunisian. So I'm using my whatever you want to call it, hooks. And they were gifted to me by Blue Mule Fiber. Love them, fantastic people. They're actually right now temporarily closed and focusing on their Blue Mule winery. And because of COVID, that's the way that they can stay open, by doing food service. And so they just don't have enough staff, since they're all family working on it, to be able to focus on yarn dyeing. So anyway, these hooks, they gave these to me, and they're so smooth. I'm so grateful for them. I do hope that I could go visit the winery at some point. I was thinking about going for my birthday, which is October 14th, but this will not be releasing till after. So what I'm saying might be changed plans for later. Anyway, I am loving the texture of this stitch. I have made so much progress already, and I just started this evening. I have like two more rows and the bind off, and this puppy is freaking done. I do find with Tunisian crochet that the return pass is like the most satisfying. I don't also work with chunky yarn very often, so this project is seeming like a breeze even more because of that. And Tunisian crochet does take like two rows to make one. So doing it in chunky makes it feel not as long, really. So I'm coming to the end of this row, and I'm gonna show you what it kind of looks like. I know it's kind of poor lighting being evening time, so I'll show you better tomorrow, but I am loving these colorways, yeah. Oh, it looks so good with that striping. Doesn't it look so like rustic and home, like just fall cozy? This colorway, both of these are Premier. This is Premier Puzzle. I've used Premier Puzzle before, and I really do like the yarn. It's 100% acrylic, and this colorway is called Crossword. And then I'm also using this Premier Serenity, and this colorway is called Cloud Dancer. But yeah, they're both 100% acrylic and both 5-weight bulky. And I got gauge with the same size as Janine, so that's freaking awesome. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and finish these few rows, and then I'm gonna go take a shower and then get back at it. And I'm wondering if maybe I could get this done like this weekend. How cool would that be? I did have intentions of getting like a sparkly yarn, but I'm kind of glad that my options weren't like so intense and overwhelming to choose from, and that, you know, the universe basically decided these colors for me. I am really gonna love this, and I think I might wear this to the races. I need to wear more of my makes there. I get more comments about it there because like I'm always working on something. But I don't know, like maybe I just feel like I don't want dirt on my things. But since this is acrylic, I could just throw it in the wash and it's way more durable. So I'm cool with that. Okay, I'll be back tomorrow where I could show you guys in the light and show you how satisfying the return passes are and how this lick a needle or hook glides so well. So, until tomorrow. Look at my stack. That is crazy. It's basically a one day's worth of work. So I've got my right panel and my left panel. So I think it goes this way. And then I've got my back panel. I am finding that I get a heck of a lean. Well, you can't see it as bad right now in this one. This is supposed to have like a slant on to get a little bit of shaping for the top. Also, if I would have thought about it, I would have just done the three panels all together at like one time, like each row at one time, so that all my striping colors could have matched a little bit better. But I'm okay with a little bit of the hodgepodge, I guess. It's all gonna be the same cozy color theme anyway. Oh, that's gonna be so cool. I can't wait. Anyway. Oh my gosh, I haven't put it together yet since that. I've had it on like as the stack. Wow. Wow. Okay, so it does say on the front panels to leave like a long length for seaming. I didn't leave like a long length for like the side seaming. I imagine I'll use the white to do that part. And I just figure that this means like a long length for the shoulder seaming. So that's what I did. I left a length basically double the size of this. Sometimes they say triple, and maybe that's what I did need was triple. Usually that's what I go for because that's the safest way. But I'm sure double will get me that way. Get me that length to seam that up on there. And it's not like I can't add yarn again later to do it. I cannot wait to try this on. Oh my gosh, and it's so squishy. Who knew that like chunky yarn and Tunisian had the capability of being so drapey? I mean, I was basically doing this to test for a friend and test for somebody new. I wasn't necessarily doing it because I like need this garment. I love cardigans, but we don't get like super cold weather here in Texas. So a chunky sweater or cardigan isn't used for me here that much. But I have a feeling this one will be. Like, I can't wait. I want to use it like right now. We're getting some serious fall vibes here. I opened my window over here in case you're wondering what I keep looking at. But we're getting some serious fall vibes with like a lot of rain and a lot of overcast. And it's like, let's see, what is the temperature? 69 degrees, it says. I don't know what the real feel is, but that's cold for me. Like, we don't have the AC on inside. When we do, I usually have it set at like 60, between 60 to like 71. And this is Fahrenheit, by the way. I know that I have friends that work in Celsius. So this is how much yarn that I have left to do the sleeves. I did get two extra balls. Like, this is
before and this is after.
So, if I have to tap into these, okay. But it would be cool if I could get, like, it's unlikely I'm going to get two sleeves out of this. But it would be cool, wouldn't it? And I do have to do ribbing also. So, no matter what, I'm definitely going to have to tap into the white. But, yeah. Okay, so since I'm going to start sleeves, I'm going to go ahead and show y'all the glide of how well it works with these hooks. Okay, so I just have to say, Janine, I don't know if it's because she's a tech editor also or what, but she has like such a clear way and clear system. It's very lovely. I love the way that she writes her patterns. So I got all the pieces done and I have this much left of my contrast color, color B, color two. And I used just a smidget of this second skein of the color A main color. And as you can see, like that's about what I had left from the first till I had to do this row and then this row. And it takes two rows to make one. I gotta say that if you are a, you know, brave beginner, you could get this done as long as you can learn how to, you know, Tunisian double stitch. You could totally do this. Everything else is like, if you've been crocheting also, it helps because all the ribbing is actual regular crocheting. Like I said, it does have some lean to all the items. Like all the panels, I have a lean to it, which is natural for Tunisian crochet. So I think that I'm gonna go ahead and steam it all and before I seam it all. And then after I seam it, I will get to do the collar. So yay.
Y'all, I'm a little bit crazy. I freaking got this done in a whopping 24 hours.
It's freaking done. Look at that drape. I mean, oh, I actually kind of like the stripes like a little crazy. I mean, they still match up, but they have like a nice gradient.
It's cool, this yarn. It's like a marled effect too.
Yeah, I'm in love. We won't talk about all these ends that I have to do, but you know, it's okay. It's okay. Really, if you could let the floats happen, but it also helped use some of those yarns to seam them together there. But it is a lot of ends to weave in. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. And then my final like wash is gonna be in the washer. Like this puppy's getting in the washer and the dryer. It's fine, it's acrylic yarn. And I know that it's nice and sturdy because I made it. Yeah, I'm pretty proud, guys. I'm pretty proud. This is a freaking quick make. I am in love. I'm gonna live in this. I really don't even want to take it off now. Oh yeah, this is so good. So good. Yeah, I'm gonna brag about this, guys. I am so proud of Janine. It is so good. You need this now. Oh, I also did end up using up the rest of my yarn to make this Beach Bay bag. Yes, so exciting. I went ahead and rinsed it and washed and dried this puppy, and it is perfect. It's got the best drape. And I did a shoot for a different test, which was summery-ish, and this is way cozy winter. And so earlier the tree was up, now the tree has fallen, or they have cut it down. So we have all kinds of like woodsy looking things that kind of make it look wintry. So I went with it.